I'm going to teach you how to read one of my paintings today. And to do that, I'm going to start off by bragging about how good my memory is. My memory is so good that I remember the first time that I saw myself in the mirror as a child. I remember being so curious to see what I looked like, and then feeling a little disappointed once I did. Now, I would later learn as an adult that this phenomenon is totally normal. It's something that Jacques Lacan coined as the mirror stage, which is the dissatisfaction that a child feels when they see themselves in the mirror for the first time, because what they think and what they feel is so much more complex than what they have being reflected back at them. And it is here where I say that the body and the self begin to become psychologically separated. Now, as we experience this society, I believe that that degree of separation can become larger. And it varies for groups of people. It varies for those that experience race, class, gender, in marginalized ways, reducing one to think of themselves in objectified ways. And women are particularly susceptible to that because of how they are represented inside visual culture. Now, just by looking at the history of art alone, the nude is one of the most iconic subjects. Last checked, 76% of the nudes at the Met Museum were female, with 96% of the artists being male. How one sees himself being represented in society affects the way that they think of themselves. And it's usually those with privilege that are determining what that representation is going to look like. So essentially, you can sum up my work as being about the objectification of female bodies. And what I do is I isolate that objectification and think of it as kind of an after image or a ghost to point to that occurrence, to subvert that current narrative. Now, why is this important? Because our visual culture shapes the way that we think. And as smart as we like to think we all are, we are not smarter than the environment we grew up in. Thank you.